Hi, assalamu alaikum and welcome back to another video. We are now exploring some beautiful places in Saudi Arabia. So let's see the route map. So our trip starts from Riyadh through the Hail Road, leading first to Sakaka. This is our first destination. Next from Sakaka, we are moving to Tabuk, which is our second destination. From Tabuk, we will be next moving to Hakkal, followed by Bada, next Magna. Traveling through the coastal areas, we will then stop at Luba, next to a beautiful beach that's at Umluj, next to Yambu, and then finally to Medina through the Badr Road, and finally back to Riyadh. So here starts our trip from Riyadh to Sakaka, which is around 1000 kilometers. We have started early in the morning after the Fajr prayer. Now stopped at a petrol station and planning to have lunch from here. So this is a Pakistani restaurant and we have ordered here some gravies along with hoops. So for the time being, we are trying this. It's not that good, but it's okay. Preparing our afternoon tea, enjoying the beautiful weather and the desert. So by evening we have reached Sakaka. Here a few friends have arranged dinner for us. So thank you once again to those friends who has arranged a delicious treat for us. Next day after checking out from hotel, preparing a simple breakfast from our car. A combination of strawberry flavored fresh cream along with some hummus and halawa. These three combinations goes well with this Arabic bread. So this is our simple breakfast for today. As you all know, Sakaka belongs to Aljov province, so we are going to explore some historical places here first. So firstly, we are going to visit the Rajajil columns. There are different opinions and stories behind these stones, but some historians say that this might be the remains of the temples during the 4th millennium BC. Next, we are visiting the two main castles in this province. First, let's have a look onto the inner part of the Zabal Castle. This castle is built on top of a mountain. The main entrance to the castle is closed. Instead, they have given here a small entrance to the heritage village, which is made as part of this castle. This castle is more than 400 years old and has been renovated many times. This has been built during the period of the Nabataeans. Here they have set up few restaurants along with a beautiful rose garden. We are now in Dumathul Jandal, which is around 50 kilometers away from Sakaka. This area is considered to be as the historical location of Aljov. The son of Prophet Ibrahim, that is Ismail, had 12 sons. One among them was named Duma. He and his people were staying at this city. Later got the name for the city as Dumatul Jandal. Now on the right side, you could see Al-Jawf Museum. Due to time limit, we did not visit this place. So next in Dumatul Jandal, we are visiting the Marid Castle, which has got lots of stories to say. Both these castles are military fortress in this Al-Jawf region. This castle dates back to the 3rd century. At that time, including Queen Zenobia, many other queens tried to invade this castle. And it wasn't that easy for them. And finally, they all failed. Mainly strong stones are used for the construction of this castle. It actually brings a different feeling while we pass through this historical castle. There is a huge source of water, mainly wells, beside the castle and even inside. At that time, the distance from Duma to Medina was 15 days. People traveling to Medina via Duma was being robbed. This complaint also reached Prophet Muhammad. He then sent his people to Duma, but the situation still continued. And then finally, the commander of the Islamic army, that's Khalid bin Walid, finally captured Dumatul Jandal along with the Marid Castle. There is also a small mosque here inside this castle. Thank you. Inside this castle, we could see two wells. One of them is this, and it is said that the water in this well is still not dried, and it is very deep. While visiting here, you should never miss walking through this path. The architectural beauty here will really amaze you. This is the other well inside the castle. There is still water in this well, and you can also hear the water pumping. The construction of this well is that there are steps made to go down the well. Close to this castle is a mosque which is named as Umar al-Khattab Mosque. This mosque is built under the order of Umar al-Khattab, who was the Khalifa during that time. It was during his return from Jerusalem, that's from Baitul Muqaddis. The speciality of this mosque is that it is the first mosque in the Islamic history to have built with minara, and its floor plan is similar to that of the mosque in Medina. That is the Prophet's Mosque, and it is also one of the very few oldest mosque in the world which is maintained as it is without disturbing the structure. Only here the mud is replaced with the cement, remain all kept as it is. Until the last 20 years, this mosque was fully live. There were prayers going on here, but now it is under the control of the archaeological department. This mosque is lying near to the Marid Castle on one side and the Doma Souk on the other side. This is the way to go to the top of the minara. So let's go and see. It's a very narrow path.
അടുത്തതാണ്.
Now it's time to leave from here. Next we are going to have lunch and then move to visit a farm. From there, by evening we would be moving to Tabuk. In the farm we will be mainly seeing olive plants. A major part of the olive production in Saudi Arabia comes from Al Jawf province. So we will be happy to see that all. So for all that, stay tuned for the next video. Until then, take care. Bye-bye.